Hello and welcome to LaproFit, India Fights Obesity. We have Dr. Raj Palaniappan with us, the head of Bariatric Surgery, Apollo Group of Hospitals, and also he's the executive board member of OSSI. Dr. Raj, happy to have you here today.
Thank you for having me.
Doctor, you've seen so many cases of obesity in India. We always hear the numbers are rising, but people only see obesity as, this is just, you do bariatric surgery, then it's weight loss. What are the other comorbidities that kind of resolve once you do a bariatric surgery?
Okay, so the whole idea of bariatric surgery itself is to improve the quality of life by improving the comorbidities. Weight loss is a byproduct, sugar, BP and cholesterol. Obesity increases it multifold. Bariatric surgery brings them down anywhere between 80 to 100%. So it can be even a cure in certain patients. Most patients it resolves from injection insulin to tablets or that medication as well. Or one tablet of hypertension or only with salt restriction. Dyslipidemia again, most likely by not in medicine as well.
Dr. Raj, let's also talk about transformation. You just mentioned how a person is able to up their quality of life thanks to bariatric surgery. Any such story or incident that you would like to share with us?
Oh yeah, we have plenty of stories to tell about. There are two stories which really impressed me. Story number one is a gentleman who was around 165, 170 kilos. Very successful man in life, but he always been sedentary. So he traveled abroad, so he has to travel buying two seats in the airline, and he wanted to do sports, he couldn't do sports. His dream in life is to do skydiving, and they said he can't because of his weight.
Oh my God.
So he came to us and wanted to do this bariatric surgery, but I said that's not the reason you need bariatric surgery, you need for quality of life. So we examined him, he had pre-diabetic, he had hypertension, and he had the sleep apnea and all those things. We operated, he lost about close to 85 kilos. The big change in his life is, he from being an executive in that company, he grew up to the level of being a manager. Because of the kind of confidence he got, professionally become better. Now, he is a full-time, what we call as a fitness freak or an activity freak. He's into scuba diving, he's into trekking, he's a biker, he skydives once in 6 months, and he's almost the most happiest person you could see around him, so bubbly and nice. So this kind of a change you can't expect for a regular weight loss programs. Another interesting thing is a woman who's been really manhandled by her husband because she's low in confidence, she's 135 kilos in the Middle East, suffering, doesn't know how to go about her life. Somehow she got courage and fought against her husband to come for bariatric surgery. Husband came for it, but then he was not very comfortable. He was always fighting with her and all those kind of things. Maybe around 8 months, 9 months down the line, the transformation. She really did so well. She did her MBA, being a housewife after her BBA, finished her MBA, joined IT in Bangalore. She divorced him, got remarried, got a kid again. Now it's been almost 7-8 years. She's in a different platform altogether. She thanks bariatric surgery day in and day out. The transformation, what it brings to a person's life, is humongous. Provided you choose the right patient. Provided we choose for the right reasons.
Absolutely, and bariatric surgery is one of the few surgeries that can be life-changing. Thank you for sharing that, Dr. Raj. Also, let's understand, taking a decision like this is not, it doesn't happen over a day. It takes that kind of time. Let's look at 2020, and I want to understand from you about obesity patient care, especially in the pre-surgery area. Okay. What do you have in mind?
So, the ideal way to look at these kind of a patients are, first is they need the motivation to lose weight. Forget about trying to convince them for bariatric surgery or something. So what we do is, when the patient comes to us, or when we send a social media awareness program, somebody gets a call, we send them, come over, we'll discuss. Let's forget about surgery. We discuss about your weight. So the first step is to scientifically get a opinion. Because we still think if you are obese, you just call your colleague, you call your friend who has lost weight, you call, go to a nutritionist and get your plan. That doesn't work all the time. It works definitely when there is no issues in your body. When it's overeating is the only issue. When there is overeating is not an issue. When there are a lot of other issues, they can't help you. And no two weight loss is the same. So get a scientific help. For the scientific help, we have something called as body composition analysis, hormone assessments. This is a must. The moment you, for example, somebody has gained more than 4 kilos a month, it's alarming. Maximum is 2 kilos. 500 grams a week is what you can gain. That also only if you overeat or you gradually keep increasing in your weight. There is no static phase of your life. Anyway, you're gradually increasing for over 6 months, 8 kilos, 10 kilos, then it's a time where you have to be concerned about it. We do this hormone test and distance, we understand what's happening. In women, most likely PCOD is the biggest culprit in all these things. Sometimes they're self-medicating, especially when they are, you know, taking contraceptive pills and stuff like that. In men, most likely it's binge eating or drinking late in the night and half a hour kind of food habits. So we try to address that lifestyle. Even if you are morbidly obese, you deserve a surgery. It's not the right way to approach straight away. So try to change their lifestyle. If they have tried all those things, they failed, and they come to you, then we have a different approach towards it. So, but at the end of the day, composition analysis, hormone assessments forms the basis, and we plan our treatment accordingly. If we think that they do well with the nutrition itself, we give a nutrition plan and give it to the nutritionist to take care of. For example, we have 100 patients every month coming to us. We do only 15 surgeries. Rest 85, we put them on some other plans, medical plan, lifestyle, physical therapy, something or other. So the ideal way is educate the public that get a physician's or scientific consultation for your weight. That should be the aim of 2020 and not promote any specialty, not promote yoga, not promote nutrition, not promote surgery. First, understand your body's weight.
Let's come to the post-surgery part of it. You know, what is your center doing? Because, you know, once you do the surgery, it just doesn't end with, you know,
yes,
just the surgery. There's so much more. So post-operative care, tell us more.
So first thing first, we have a helpline. For any patient coming to a department, we give them the 24-hour helpline number, and that helpline is not just with the manager or coordinator, is with our nutritionist, and he is magnanimous enough to accept to be approachable 24/7. The reason behind that is, any patient, the first issue that comes post-operatively is with eating. Suddenly 2 o'clock, they say, I'm middle of a party, I overeat, I have difficulty, I have vomiting, I feel weak. So the nutritionists are the first point of contact to really explain to you that doing some kind of a diet adjustments, things can change. And there should be some education time to time. What happens at 1 month? What happens at 2 months? What happens at 3 months? But unfortunately, you cannot put all the information in on one go. So what we'll do is we'll just give them a gist, and what we conduct as a support group meeting every month. We call the patients group, patients who have underwent 5 years, surgery 5 years before, 3 years before, a year before, 6 months before, 3 months before, even a person who underwent last week. All those people come. Pre-operative people also will be called for it, who have been waiting for surgery. So these people can interact with them informally about finding out what happens post-operatively. And post-op patients, 1 week patients can discuss a 3 month patient to understand what will happen at 3 months. Three month patient can talk with a 1 year patient, 5 years patient. So we'll have a various group of patients. We have a database of 100-150 patients who are willing to talk. So we'll pick few of them, call them for a support group meeting, and make them informally learn with them. And then of course we are there to give them a feedback whenever we want. And worst come worst, we need to have a doctor in their areas, because 50% of our patients are from outstation. So we identify surgeons from across the state and across the country and across the globe as well. 6 months back, one of our patients had some issues in the US. We could call one of our friend in US, and she's consulting them. So, you know, at every point in your life, something goes wrong. There should be some care given to them. So that kind of a support, both professional support, emotional support, and as well as a group through patient support. All these things we cover up, and most of our patients are very happy with that.
Absolutely. So there's a hotline, you know, 24/7 care, a hand-holding over many years. That's what really makes it a success story. I'm sure you know about the big breakthrough that's coming from the IRDA, where they're saying you're going to get insured. It's made a lot of patients happy. Your thoughts on that, Dr. Raj?
Okay. Thanks to IRDA. First of all, thanks to the government. In 2014-15, they made it defined it as a disease. And CGHS has started approving it. Then the state government in Tamil Nadu has, in their scheme, has approved last year. IRDA pushed it through, and we are lucky to have insurance covering bariatrics. But again, they are allowed to use bariatrics for a claim from October 2019, but October 2020 is the time. IRDA has very clearly said that if any policy doesn't cover bariatrics, that policy ceased to exist. That's a very, very strong statement from IRDA. Hats off to IRDA being so strong in saying that bariatrics has to be accepted in every policy. If they come with some kind of a clear premium or a top-up, whatever is required for that, it's pretty good. Touch wood, from 2020, we are going to be much more obese-free world than before.
Fantastic. We're working towards an obesity-free world, obesity-free India, a happy, healthy India, and you're all the people who are working towards that. Finally, your call to action for India Fights Obesity.
Okay. Call to action, governments, NGOs, and bariatric organization should start working together. Government is working in their own ways, our association working in our own ways, and NGOs are working in their other ways. So there should be a more greater call, and thanks to the present Fit India movement, things have started getting, you know, getting some pace. So I think like NGO with India for Obesity and some other companies will have their NGO as well for weight loss, and Bariatric Association, government should work together and form protocols, like, because this is a lifestyle disease. It cannot be brushed down the carpet like a hernia or appendix or a gallbladder, because if you don't do this now, we are going to be the most sick country in the world by 2030. That is not good. With geriatric population picking up, we are in a very, very alarming state. When we have most amount of, more than 60%, 70% of population is over 60, and you have so much of disease in the country, we will be the sickest country in the world. So we had to be very, very careful about it. The actions should start from schools. That is lacking. I always keep saying, I hate the school system in India where we don't have a playground, where there's nothing called a PET class anymore. Everything is
exams
and things like that. So there should be a 1 hour of physical education every day for these kids. There should be some kind of awareness given to them. My son's school has a small canteen which sells chips, burgers, pizzas. Replace them with a healthy food. Make sure that certain rules are given to the school. This much of a playtime, this much of a playground should be there, this much of a candy should not have junks. Start there. How long can you pretend that, you know, we are okay? No. Start from school, give education, and in workplace also there should be some norms. Like government has passed a CSR, like, you know, that there should be some, this kind of a CSR should be done, this kind of a 10% of infrastructure has to be for greens. Same way, you should say these kind of things for nutrition and things has to be followed in every working place. So unless we make it that strict, we cannot survive this beyond 30-40 years when we become the most sickest country in the world.
Okay, let's not head in that direction. There are ways to do it. Thank you for explaining it so beautifully. Dr. Raj Palaniappan, it's been a pleasure to have you here at LapraFit. Thank you so very much.
Thank you.